Hey, Sarah here from Singer's Advice. Today, I'm doing a vocal react to the one and only, the amazing Whitney Houston singing I Have Nothing live. Here we go. This is one of my all-time favorite songs of Whitney Houston. Back phrasing from the original recording. Altering the melody, altering the phrasing. You know, she knows this song so well. She can pretty much do whatever she likes with it, and she knows exactly where she is. That's Whitney Houston, isn't it? That note there. That depth. The soul, the kind of... the very low larynx sound, even when she's going higher up, she keeps that depth and that kind of fallen back soul placement. Don't talk, don't walk away from me. I love it when singers alter the song from like the original recording when they sing it live, because it just gives the song a new sound, a new depth, a new journey. It'd be boring if they just sang it exactly the same as the record. Beautiful ad-libs that are just perfect. It's like they're just there, they're effortless. She stays in that chest belt sound pretty much the whole time, but still manages to make it colourful and different sounding with the phrasing. The pattern of the the melodic phrasing and the just beautifulness. Dynamics, obviously. You know, she's not switched really. And that vibrato. Whitney Houston vibrato. Here she goes. When you think she can't get any bigger. Oh. She having a mouth then. Just easy. Boop. Just pop that note out. Still got that sound going on, even that high up, and that's hard. Thank you. First time she's flicked into a different register, really. She can just hold you. Holds you on her words. Sign of a good singer that can hold an audience like that. There she goes. Woo! Whitney classic. I mean, she's a belter. You know, she was an absolute queen of belt, and the way she did it with such depth and sort of heaviness in a way, even when she got higher up in her range, even as she moved through, you know, she doesn't really switch registers, she stays there but still manages to give it difference. You know, she's not, it's not heavy on your ears. She's not whacking it out so much. And you know what that is? It's because the sort of twang in there, it's very low on the dial. Yeah, there's a lot more kind of low, kind of a bit sort of low larynx, drop back placement. Instead of forwards, that's giving it that depth and that wonderful sound that she gets, that richness, that soulfulness. And yeah, I mean, she flicked twice towards the end of the song just for effect, and that was very much classic Whitney. You know, she'd flick into a different register, flick into that kind of more thin foldy place, head voice, you know, to just give it a difference towards the end, just like she did in I Will Always Love You. And that song for me is absolutely wonderful. And I love the way she changed it. And I love the way she altered the melody and altered the phrasing and made it different and took that audience on a journey hearing the song as if, again, for the first time. When you see a singer like that live, you don't really want to just hear it as it is on the record. Well, at least I don't. I love that. I love it when you hear different things going on and they're just showing their performance skills and all that, you know. And even though you're used to hearing a song like that so many times, probably back in the 90s, you know, on the radio all the time, to hear it like that is so special and so much more. To me, obviously, the record is unbelievable, but that for me is beautiful and takes you on a journey. And she was just so amazing, obviously one of the best singers there has ever been. You know, when you listen to Whitney Houston, I don't listen to her and hear a load of vocal technique. Obviously it's there, it was natural, it was big, it was coming from within her, it was beautiful, and it was her voice, it was her true voice. It's more voice craft for me, that. I listen to that and it's just, it's seamless and beautiful and just amazing. So what did you think of that performance from Whitney Houston? Let me know in the comments what makes Whitney the greatest singer there ever was. Let me know what else you might like me to do a react on. So thanks for joining me. Don't forget, if you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video every Thursday. If you haven't already got the free training, then you can get that by clicking the link below this video, and you will get 3 fantastic exercises to develop your vocal technique. So I'll see you next time at Singer's Advice.